There's nothing quite like sitting out on a balmy Australian summer night next to a campfire watching the stars. But everyone knows a good campfire needs a good campfire story. And I think I've got just the one. It's as wild as the wilderness, as deep as our DNA, and as wide as the span of the animal kingdom. Best of all, it's a true tale. But don't worry, sometimes the truth is stranger than fiction.
Let me describe an animal for you. Carnivorous, a head shaped a bit like a fox, a jaw that can open impossibly wide, nearly 90 degrees, stripes but only on the back half, shaped a bit like a dingo, and it has a pouch like a kangaroo. These are the features of the Tasmanian tiger, or thylacine. For those non-Australians out there, Tasmania is an island state located south of the Australian mainland, where the eponymous Tasmanian tiger was mostly found.
The last captive thylacine died in a Tasmanian zoo in 1936, and the species was declared extinct shortly after. Farmers of the late 19th century loathed the thylacine, and the species' notoriety at the time earned farmers a £1 bounty for each animal killed.
Now, compared to the death of the last thylacine, the field of genetics is comparatively young. While the idea of a gene can be dated back to Gregor Mendel in 1865, the chemical structure of DNA, the building blocks of our genes, was only discovered in 1953, and it wouldn't be until 1995 that an organism's entire genome would be sequenced for the first time, giving rise to the field of genomics, the study of genes and their interactions at the level of the whole genome.
That brings us back to the thylacine, and a 2018 research article by Dr. Charles Fagan and colleagues. The group extracted ancient DNA from a thylacine joey preserved in alcohol by Museums Victoria, and used it to compile the first full thylacine genome. Now, bear in mind, at the time of publication, the thylacine had been extinct for 82 years, and the sample was even older, 105 years to be exact. Now, this is all well and good, but why sequence the genome of an extinct species?
One reason was to clarify where the thylacine sits in the great phylogenetic tree of life. By identifying retroposons, short non-protein coding sections of DNA that are inserted into the genome over millennia, and tracking the conservation of these short DNA sections between species, the researchers were able to build the case that the thylacine was a basal lineage of the Dasyuromorphia, which also includes the families of other extant Australian marsupials, including the numbat in the family Myrmecobiidae, and the quoll, dunnart, and Tasmanian devil in the family Dasyuridae. Secondly, the thylacine is a widely regarded example of convergent evolution. Ordinarily, we think of evolution as a divergent process, where organisms become ever more different from each other and fill various niches. However, some species develop similar traits despite their great phylogenetic distance. In the case of the thylacine, the group looked at skull shape compared to other Dasyuromorphia, as well as Caniformia, the suborder that includes dogs, wolves, foxes, and many other dog-like species. Skull shape is an excellent predictor of feeding habits amongst both canine and marsupial species, and the morphological variations that predict carnivorous behaviour in one similarly predict it in the other. However, compared to the class Carnivora to which Caniformia belongs, Dasyuromorphia are believed to have diverged from the phylogenetic tree over 160 million years ago. Taken alongside the fact that the geometry of the thylacine skull shares much in common with the skull of the red fox and the grey wolf, this suggests that the thylacine has developed a skull shape suited to carnivorous feeding independently of these species. And understanding the genetic basis of this convergence is an ongoing question. While the group didn't find evidence of genetic convergence in protein coding regions in their 2018 paper, they would go on to release a publication in 2019 describing significant convergence in the regulatory regions of genes between the thylacine and the grey wolf.
Genomics is a deep and rapidly expanding field of inquiry. And while its impact on medicine is grand, on agriculture great, and ecology difficult to understate, I hope I've convinced you that the species we've lost to time may yet surprise us and teach us about the nature of life in its inconceivable grandness. Our thylacine friend may be extinct, but she's certainly not forgotten.